In this video, we are going to look at some image processing techniques with Streamlit. So I've created this app and implemented some image processing algorithms. So on the left, you can choose one of the following. So let's go and see what we have in image processing. So I'll show you what this app does, and after that we can look at the code. So when you choose image processing, you get this particular page, and it says thresholding, edge detection and contours. So what I've done is I have a slider at the top which changes the threshold value. So right now it's 50, and so this is the thresholding image that we get. So if I slide this to maybe 111, it changes. So if I do more, the value will be 160, and this is the image that we'll get. Alright, so to see the original image, you can click on this button and this will pop out. So you can see how we can easily use Streamlit to do these tasks, right? Along with that, Streamlit provides you with bar charts and other plots that you can use for your images. If you want to know more about data visualization, you can see my previous video on Streamlit. So for this particular, I have plotted a bar chart for this particular image. This. Alright, so you can look at the bar chart here, and then I've also implemented a edge detection technique. There are multiple edge detection techniques like Sobel also, but I've only implemented one for demo purposes. So when I click on this button, it will run the edge detection technique on one of the images, which is Jerry, the image of Jerry, and then this is the output. So in a similar way, I've taken another image for seeing the contours on the image. So right now the value of to find the contours is 50. So when I click on this button, this is the it is detecting contours on this particular image. So if I increase the value of 50 to maybe let's say 116, and then click back on the button. So, you know, as you can see, the number of contours have increased. So it was able to understand the image in a much better way. And so this is what I wanted to show you in image processing and how you can use Streamlit with it. All right. Then what we have the next is video. So in video, I wanted to show a feature that Streamlit recently came up with is the file uploading. So if you have a video, then you can simply display the video on your Streamlit app, or if you want to choose a file, then you can. So we'll look at the code of this also later. So I'll show you, you can browse file. You can do this in like two or three lines of code, the browse file and everything. I click on this particular image, on this particular video, open. As you can see, it has, you can display the video and you can, you know, view it. So this particular entire thing, browse file and everything, you can do in like three lines of code using Streamlit. Right, let's look at the next part. Now we have face detection. So for face detection, I'm using a Hardcastcat file, and so I've taken an image of me and my friends, and it has it was able to detect the images and the faces in the image properly. So let's see the original image. So this was the original image. And this is the images after detecting the faces. Okay. So you can display the images here on Streamlit. Right. So let's see feature detection. So I'm assuming that you guys are aware about some feature detection techniques that we have in computer vision. So SIFT, then we have FAST, and we also have SURF, and there are many other feature detectors. Okay. So I've taken one image, and I've implemented SIFT and then FAST on the same image, and as you can see, the number of key points detected is 1277 for SIFT and 2057 for FAST. Right? So you can display the output like this on Streamlit, and you know, and view it in a much better way. So this is the feature detection. And the last we have object detection. So again, I've used some different Hardcastcat files. So this is the wall clock our cascade file, and I've taken this image, and it was able to detect the ball club on the wall properly. And then we have detecting eyes. So I've taken this image and it has detected the eyes. It also detected this particular eye. So this is quite blur, and still the algorithm was able to identify at least one of the eyes. So it's good. It has also detected some different features. So, you know, that those are not eyes, but it has still detected them. Okay. So now let's look at the code and how we can implement this. So this is the code, and so we are importing all the libraries that we are going to use, and I have a main function, and this is the starting point of the app, you could say. So I'm calling the function here, main. So I have a sidebar. So on the home page that you see, one second. So this is the home page and this is the sidebar that you see. So Streamlit gives you a very simple way of building this sidebar. So Streamlit, you know, Streamlit dot sidebar, and then you simply say select box, and you can enter whatever values you want in that select box. So welcome. So I've, you know, all the things that you see here is what you see here, right? So after that, what I've done is if the selected box is any one of the following, then I'm calling that particular function, right? So if welcome selected, call this function. If image processing is selected, then call the photo function, right? So by default, it is taking welcome. See, welcome, and then you're seeing this, right? So let's look at this particular function, the welcome function, and what we have in the welcome function. Now we have the title. So with Streamlit, you can simply say st.title, and you know, you get this particular title in bold, right? And at the bottom we have st.subheader. So it also has header and text and write, st.write, st.subheader, st.header, right? So I'm using subheader here, and I've entered whatever I wanted to say, right? And it is displayed here. Okay, the next we have the image. I've taken this image of Hacker Shrine, and we can display the image simply by, you know, saying st.image, and you pass the image that you have, that you want, and you know, it will be displayed over there. So if you don't say use column width equal to true, then the image won't fit here. It will be bigger than this. So if you want to fit this in this particular column, then you have to make this true. All right. Okay, so this was the welcome function. Now let's go to the image processing function. So here we have the thresholding, edge detection, and contours. So in this, the first thing that I have used is the header to display the title, the header, I mean. And after that, I have a button. So if you want to create a button in Streamlit, you simply say if st.button, and then you pass what you want to say for that button. So this is the placeholder of that button. Okay. So the if statement, why do we need the if statement? So if the user clicks on the button, then it goes inside the if statement, and this is what is displayed. All right. So I've set the original image of Tom. So when I click on this image, it displays the original image, because it opens that particular image. So the Tom image is loaded, and that particular image is displayed. Okay, so when you click on the button, it goes inside the if statement. Next, what we have is the image that we were using for thresholding. So the slider. So we have a slider, and you can simply make a slider saying st.slider with the placeholder change threshold value, and you can set the minimum value and the maximum value. So we are working with images. So for thresholding, it goes from 0 to 255, and that's why you have 0 to 255, and you can slide over this. So this is the slider that you see. Now is where the OpenCV part comes into picture. So we have a cv2.threshold function, and we pass the image that we have loaded, and now we need to change the image based on the slider. Right, so we have the minimum value and the maximum value, and that is stored in the value x. So we can pass this x in the threshold function here. Right, so you can change the slider and the value of x changes, hence the threshold image that we get also changes, and you can simply display the thresh one variable in the st.image function. Alright, now in the documentation, if you see the documentation, if you want to display the OpenCV images that you have used, and then make sure you have clamp equal to true. Alright, so if this is false, it's not going to work. It will throw an error. It will say that clamp is not set. So make sure you set the clamp to true, so you can view the image. Alright, so when I change this to 127, you know, this has changed now. If I go beyond 230 or something, it is completely black. Alright, next we have the bar. So you can use a bar chart function that we have in Streamlit and pass a value. So the value is based on the calculations that the calc hist makes on that particular image. Alright, so this is the image that we have loaded here. Okay, so I'm using the cv2.calchist function, and then I'm passing that value in the bar chart function of Streamlit, and then that this is what you're viewing on your app. Alright, great. So the next part that we have is the canny edge detection. So similar way, the way we did for thresholding, we have edge detection, and I've created a button with canny edge detector as a placeholder. I'm loading the image, I'm calling the canny function, and then I'm again passing the displaying the image on Streamlit. Alright, so this is the canny edges, and then I have clamp equal to true. That's why we see here. So when I click on the button, it goes inside the if statement, and all the other things are loaded, and we get this as the output. Okay, now we have the contours. So I've created another slider for contours, and I have another button for displaying the images. Alright, so the Jerry is the different image of Jerry that I've taken. I've loaded the image, I've performed the contours by finding the contours and then drawing the contours on the image, and in the end using again st.image to display the contours. Alright, so let's see that again. Make this 115 or something and click on contours. You get both the images along with the contours drawn on the original image. Great, now we have video. So as I said, there's a very simple way of making this browse file, drag and drop file here using Streamlit. Let's see how we can do that. So Streamlit gives you the file underscore uploader function, which you can use. And when you say that, it will, if you say st.file uploader, it will create this particular area for browsing the files and dropping the files here. Right? So if you choose a file, if you choose a file which says the uploaded file is not none, meaning that you have chosen a file, you will read that file. So in this case, I'm opening a video file, but of course you can use a image or a CSV file also. Okay, so I'm reading the file, and then using the st.video function in Streamlit, I'm just displaying it again. Alright, so in this way you can choose a file and then display it. So in this case it was video, but you can go for images and CSV files also if you're working with data. Okay, and if you already have a file which you don't want the user to choose, then you can simply pass the name of the file, and then you can display it using st.video again. Right, let's look at the phase detection. So as I said, I'm using a hard cascade file, and I have the header now, and then a button to see the original image the way we saw for the thresholding part. And we have the hard casket file here. So the hard casket frontal face default XML file I'm using. This is the face casket variable which I'll be using to detect the multi-scale, to call the multi-scale function for the image that we are loading. So this image is the image of my friends that I want to detect faces from. Okay, and after that I'm using the cv2.rectangle to draw a rectangle across around the face, right? And again I'm using st.image to display the image that you are seeing here. This is the image with the rectangles around the faces. Okay, if you want to save the images, then you can use cv2.imwrite and give the name that you want and it will save the image. Okay, so as you can see, I have here, so this is the image, it has saved local machine. Okay, next we have the feature detection. So in feature detection, you know SIFT, SURF and FAST. There are many other feature detectors we have. I'm showing you only two. So I'm using loading an image, which is the image of Tom, and then converting it into gray, and then using X features 2D, and then SIFT create function. All right, this will get the features of from your image, and then you can detect it, and you can have it in a variable called key points. And you know, you can, if you say length of key points, then you can see how many key points that you have. So this is what you are seeing here. So this is what you are seeing, the length of key points. Okay, so then you can draw the key points on the image. And in the again you can st.image to display it on your Streamlit app. Make sure again you have this clamp equal to true, otherwise it's not going to work. And you have done the same thing for fast as well. Okay, so if you're not aware about the algorithms, make sure you Google it and learn about this before you get into this part. The video is more concerned upon how you can use Streamlit with image processing and not on completely on computer vision techniques. All right. Then the last thing that we have is object detection. So I have a header, Streamlit header, and the Streamlit subheader, and I'm loading an image of a clock. Okay, converting that image into RGB and gray, and you can use the cascade hard cascade file, the wall clock file, and call the detect multi-scale function to see if you find a clock in that image or not. So if it's found, great, then you can draw a rectangle around it and display back that image on the Streamlit app. Okay, so for eyes, detecting eyes, you have another cascade file, that is the hard cascade eye XML file. And then if you find eyes in your images, you can draw a rectangle, and we have seen this already. Let's look at it once more. So the rectangle we have drawn, and we will have the image, the eye detection also. So these are the eyes detected by the algorithm. All right, so if you go through the code once, you will understand it better. I have the entire code on my GitHub. I will provide the link to the GitHub in the description below, and you can go through this code. You're free to add stuff to this application, so you know it will be better for others also to understand how this Streamlit works with computer vision. And you can do multiple other things also using Streamlit. So this was a way of showing you how you can use Streamlit with OpenCV. I hope you liked this video. I think hoping you find this informative. If you like our content, please like, share and subscribe, and thank you.